these are props from movies that mean so much to me. That it's just literally fascinating being close enough to touch them. Not that I touched it. I resisted the urge. So it's a Friday. Pat took off work specifically for Harry Potter Celebration, which is an annual event that Universal puts on, just kind of celebrating the series and inviting cast members and people who work on the movies. It is super busy today, obviously. I mean, look at that. So we're heading in.
Yeah, we're gonna go have fun. Let's go.
What Harry Potter means to you board, which I'm gonna write on, of course. There's photo opportunities with some Quidditch gear and a little quaffle game. There's the Warner Brothers studio tour again. Mina Lima. And then of course there's the merch over here. That's pretty great.
Let's go see Mina Lima. Because the ones are characters. Everyone has their own.
Kat's gonna play the quaffle game. Quaffle game, Quidditch. Jesus, like I haven't devoted the last 15 years of my life to the franchise, and I call it quaffle game. Hey, you're pretty good at that.
Five for five, I'm good.
Woo! My turn, so there's a comparison of failure.
You won't fail. You got this.
How many have I got?
That was four, I think. One more.
I'm gonna try to
get backwards. Show off. Yeah, no.
And then just like last year, they have the big writing board where everybody writes what Harry Potter means to them.
It's okay, I got you writing it. I appreciate that.
Oopsie. Gonna try to get into the studio tour. Same one from the movie. Femina Lima is back. They have a panel too. Some big screens talking about Universal Japan, Orlando, which is us, and Hollywood.
That's me.
Yeah, right.
That's pretty cool. Slytherin gear, Gryffindor gear.
Sure. I'm gonna get the hat. Jacket.
I love some of the display stuff. All right. Do you wanna head out?
Yeah.
We're kind of broke this go around. But we have the other soundstage to hit up today to do the second half of the expo, so. So how happy are you to be out of the thick of the crowd?
Very. It's a little bit much in there.
Yeah, they let way too many people in at once.
I don't mind big crowds as long as we're outside. It's so cramped feeling in there with the way that they have it set up. I'm just like, oh, no.
Yeah. And the lighting is very dark. It's very anxiety inducing. And there's Severus Snape in line for a drink. So we're doing the movie on the lawn thing for a little bit while we're eating lunch. Kind of taking a break before we go to the next expo.
The next room of chaos in Harry Potter.
Kat's making fun of me, but I love that shot so much. I guess I forget like how great this cinematography, I think is the word that I'm looking for, is in like the first movie. The first two movies honestly are just so beautifully done. And I forgot just how breathtaking they are for a number of reasons. But watching it like on the big screen is really cool. Especially like just chilling on super fake grass at the theme park. It's like nice.
What are you doing? Stop
filming you while you're eating.
I can't stop eating the sandwich though.
Yeah, we got I always want to call them Planet Subs. Public Sub. Because they're on sale. And they're cheaper than actual theme park food. This isn't quite as well maintained as a queue line. I don't like this at all. No, I know we've been here, like over in this area, you're right, TNA. Okay, so this is much less crowded. I'm guessing people are not finding this half of the expo. So this is the other expo hall. They've got a Lego Dimensions demo going on, an Audible demo going on. They've got the Harry Potter fan mosaic that they're making out of Instagram pictures, a cursed child display thing that we're waiting in line for now, and then the VR experience.
So this is Albus Severus's wand here, and then this one is Scorpius's wand, if you guys are familiar. Mm-hmm. And then this is kind of the image from the souvenir program of them using the banners that are behind you in the ensemble. And then the theater itself is very immersive, so they actually have this wallpaper all throughout the audience section of the theater. And then they have these sconces, or two out of the eight designs that we have. They have Gryffindor and Slytherin, and then they obviously have Hufflepuff and Ravenclaw, and then they have four dragons. And these are found not only on stage, they're also found within the house and also in the facade.
It's pretty cool.
Okay.
Thank you for repeating that for me.
Oh, no problem. It's what I'm here for.
I'm like such a nerd for stuff like this. Like all the costume design is just kind of making me giddy. I mean, look at that. I'm not a fan of what I've heard of the story, but I'd still really love to go see it.
So we've been waiting in this line for like...
Oh, yes.
There I am. We've been waiting in this line for like an hour. It'll be about an hour and a half every time we get up there, which is the longest we've really been doing anything so far. But it's for the VR experience, so it's kind of worth waiting. I'm really interested. We haven't done anything in VR yet. I'm really interested in how that's going to go.
Your neon hair makes you look so much more ridiculous. So you can see it even without your glasses?
Yeah. Oh no, I just grabbed them and drank them.
Stuff like creatures or
yeah,
stuff like...
Yeah, well, just stuff to look at. Because of the screaming.
So it has you doing tasks?
Yeah.
That's cool.
And why do they do it in the main drink? This is so cool. So you're like...
Oh, in his case.
What'd you think?
That's pretty cool. It's kind of slow with the response, so it took a long time to actually get to it. I didn't actually get to see the rhino, but it was a pretty cool looking room.
That's neat.
Yeah. Are you figuring it out? What part are you at?
I just opened the case. My eyesight's pretty bad, so at first I was like looking in the totally wrong room. Oh, I set off the mandrake too.
Yeah.
I guess it's just a natural inclination to like
poke it, yeah. There's a scroll there. If you click on it, it should give you directions on what to do with your wand.
It's so weird. Like, I just really feel the urge to like lean forward to be able to see more clearly because
Yeah.
I keep forgetting that it's like a video game.
Just make sure that you do your scroll though, because you're gonna run out of time. Doing the potion takes a couple minutes.
Oh man, that's so sad.
This isn't the creepiest thing I've ever seen. Yep, that's pretty creepy. So this is pretty great. It's the Weasley's car. It's, there's some, like, banging upness, and I don't know if it's, because the prop has been stored where people can touch it, or if it's just intentional. I mean, some of this, like, the rust spots and stuff is obviously intentional wear for the aesthetic of it being a trashed car. It's pretty interesting to see it. Like, it's by interesting, I think I mean, like, surreal. These are props from movies that mean so much to me. That it's just literally fascinating being close enough to touch them. Not that I touched it. I resisted the urge. Audible has a booth where you listen to the audiobooks. So that's really interesting.
So everyone is submitting photos with the hashtag HB celebration. And this one is going to be a picture of the Hogwarts castle made of fan photos.
That unless other people...
It's so cool.
This is the part where I just pick everything up and look at it. This is nice.
That's the design from everybody's t-shirts that are working today, right?
Yeah, it's for this year's celebration. There's like a baseball jersey of it. It's kind of dark though, so you can't really... Can't see it. The lighting in here is awful. I'll just find things that are pre-lit.
Hello.
Hello.
Is
leggings. Yeah, those are cute.
That's cool. Yeah, let me take that for a second.
Yeah,
I am taller. The lighting's not very... There we go. It's a replica of Hogwarts, and it's absolutely gorgeous.
Like the books underneath it.
Yeah. The creature vault, the artifact vault. Tons of phone cases, which we can never buy because our phones are like... Yeah. Some regular Hogwarts mugs, socks.
I need this.
Oh, how much are those?
Training on tiptoes. $50.
$50 isn't bad. Hedwig plushes. I like this bag.
Ooh, feel it.
You are so in love with like diary stuff.
It's parchment paper. See, and then they got little...
Oh, those are awesome. Those are styled like composition notebooks. That's not bad.
I'm not showing the price of
different houses.
I like that they're all rumply.
Yeah.
25.
That's actually not as bad as I was expecting. So we came out of the soundstage there, which, just to note, is just as creepy as coming in. And up over here, that is a really great view of a part of the coaster that I have not seen before. Back through the weird, awkwardly cobbled together queue. But here's another angle of the coaster, which is so cool. Wow. Way to make me dizzy. That's so awesome. So would you ride it?
Maybe.
Maybe.
But not today.
Not today. That seems to be your answer whenever I ask if you're gonna ride a coaster.
Yeah, that's the joke. I don't wanna let anybody down. If I said yes, it wouldn't be funny.
Hey, you guys look fantastic. So we're back over on the lawn now. This is one of my favorite aspects of this event, is just everybody chilling out here on the lawn. Kat got us some snacks, and we were gonna go back and sit over there, but we got interrupted. The post-parade rush of literally everybody that got trapped by it. A seat, and Kat is gonna eat a pretzel with yellow mayonnaise.
But it's not yellow mayonnaise.
It is mustard.
Yellow mayonnaise. Realized I didn't come by to see it all finished.